Premiere Pro Warp Stabilizer versus DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer. Both of these tools will give you smooth footage, but which one is better? Hey, I'm Matt Johnson, and welcome to my new series where I put video editing software head to head and tell you which tools and effects and features are better. So if you are someone that likes to argue about which video editing software is superior, you're going to love this series. And you can also feel free to tell me that I'm wrong about any of the things that we're going to talk about down in the comments below. Sign up, by the way, I already have videos showing you the absolute best settings to use both for Warp Stabilizer and DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer, and I'll link to both of those videos in the video description. And while you're down there, I will also link to my edit videos like a pro guide that's going to show you some of the biggest tips that I have for you as a video editor, regardless of whether you are editing in Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve or even Final Cut? What? So check that guide out. It is completely free and linked in the video description. Starting off with the first big difference between Warp Stabilizer and DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer is how you apply the effect. With Premiere Pro, we have a clip here that I filmed at a wedding on a very windy day, and as you can see, there's a decent amount of camera shake. I had my camera on a gimbal, but it was a glide cam, not an electronic gimbal, and you can see there's just a bit of wobble, and at the end of this video, there's a lot of wobble as I was kind of trying to back up. So can we stabilize this clip? Well, with Premiere Pro, all you have to do is go over to your effects panel, click on Warp Stabilizer, drag it over to your clip, and it will immediately start analyzing your clip in the background, all the while you can keep editing. Alternatively, and arguably worse for productivity, you have DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer, which to access it, all you have to do is select the video clip that you want to stabilize, go over to the inspector panel, and then down to stabilization, and click stabilize. And whenever you do that, the reason this is worse than Premiere Pro is that DaVinci Resolve will not analyze your video clip for stabilization in the background. It will instead pop up a window that will not allow you to do anything until it finishes analyzing. This can really put a damper on your productivity because if you're in the zone making a lot of edits very quickly, suddenly you have to completely stop what you're doing and wait for DaVinci Resolve to analyze your video clip. So for this, even though it was very quick in Resolve because this was a very short video clip, I'm still gonna have to give the edge to Premiere Pro because it analyzes and stabilizes in the background. That said though, once you have told either of these programs that you want to analyze a video clip for stabilization, this is where DaVinci Resolve doesn't start looking so shabby because Resolve is capable of analyzing video clips for stabilization significantly faster than Premiere Pro. If you go to apply stabilization to a video clip in Resolve, it will usually analyze pretty darn quickly. I hit reset here, hit stabilize again, and takes a few seconds, it's very fast. Whereas with Premiere Pro, on the other hand, if you have not analyzed it, you bring it over Warp Stabilizer and it's kind of got to think about it for a little bit, just a bit longer than Resolve. Of course, this all depends on the length of the clip, its resolution, and the speed of your computer. But the choice for you is really going to come down to whether you want DaVinci Resolve to analyze your clip faster, but not allow you to do anything else, or Premiere Pro to take longer, but analyze your clip in the background so you can keep working. Now, before we finish talking about analyzing a clip, I do want to make you aware of one big difference between how these two programs handle analysis. And this has the potential to get you in big trouble with any clients that you're working for as a video editor, so pay attention. Here's the deal. Whenever you apply Warp Stabilizer to a clip, it should automatically start analyzing the video. But occasionally, Resolve will stop the analysis, and instead you're going to be presented with this big banner that says, click analyze to begin. And unfortunately, by default, this banner is going to be visible whenever you export your video. Thankfully, Adobe added the ability for Premiere Pro to warn you if you have a Warp Stabilizer applied to any clips that have not been analyzed, so you'll be aware of this banner and you can go back and then click the analyze button so that your footage is analyzed. But back in the day when Warp Stabilizer was first introduced, you actually had to go through every single video clip manually and make sure that if you added Warp Stabilizer to it, it was properly applied and working and there wasn't a big banner. Otherwise, you could send a video off to your client and then get a confused email back from them being like, hey, why is there a blue banner telling me that the footage needs to be analyzed? You could also ask me how I know that because I've done that with a client in the past. Or if you want a more terrifying visualization, I've seen an Instagram reel of a video signboard in Times Square that had this Warp Stabilizer Analyze banner still on it. That's terrifying. And I'm so glad that DaVinci Resolve does not have a banner like this on any of your video clips that have not been analyzed by its stabilizer. So I think that Adobe's trying to be helpful with this banner, but I'm still gonna have to give the edge to DaVinci Resolve in this case. Now, once either of these programs has analyzed your clips, let's talk about how well both of these tools work out of the box, because it wouldn't matter how long these clips take to analyze if either of these stabilization tools sucked and didn't give you stable footage. Thankfully, in my opinion, both of these tools have the potential to give you great image stabilization, but because we are specifically talking about how well they work out of the box as soon as you apply them, I have to give the edge to DaVinci Resolve, because in my experience, if you apply Resolve Stabilizer to any clip, there's a very good chance that's going to look really smooth and stable without any artifacts or other major issues. Alternatively though, with Premiere Pro, by default, Warp Stabilizer sets its smoothness, which is also the stabilization strength level, to 50%, which in my experience is a very high level of stabilization. And because of this, Warp Stabilizer can definitely be a bit overzealous, let's say, when it comes to stabilizing a clip, and it will essentially try to over-stabilize it, which can then result in this dreaded jello effect, which if you've used Warp Stabilizer for any period of time, I'm sure you're likely aware of this. It's where your footage gets really wiggly and warpy and kind of looks like a bowl of jello here, because Warp Stabilizer is attempting to overcompensate and remove every single bit of camera shake, and it just makes the footage look really weird. Alternatively, with Resolve, you don't really have that happen here. At the end of the clip, it shakes, but you can still tell that it was intentional camera shake. It doesn't have that jello-y effect nearly as much. Thankfully, I have good news. If you haven't watched my best settings for Warp Stabilizer video, I want you to know that I've created a set of presets for Warp Stabilizer that will dial back the intensity of this tool, and you can use these presets to get a much more natural and better looking Warp Stabilizer effect in just one click in Premiere Pro. These presets are going to save you a lot of time, and I have better news, they are completely free, and you can download them at the link in this video description. In short, if you use Premiere Pro, you need these presets to help you make Warp Stabilizer look its best, and I would highly recommend downloading them. I use them in almost every video that I edit in Premiere Pro. So as far as out-of-the-box stabilization quality goes, I'm going to give the edge to DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer, but let's move on here, because each of these plugins gives you a lot of tools and customization that will enable you to tweak and modify the stabilization so it looks its best. We've already talked about one of these tools that allows you to lower the intensity of Warp Stabilizer, which I made presets for, but there are also a lot of other tools as well. Both Premiere and Resolve include settings that enable you to fine-tune your stabilization, with Premiere having a checkbox down here under Advanced that will enable you to do a detailed analysis to analyze your clip and stabilize it better. You also have sliders to control the framing for your shot, extra scaling, cropping, etc. And there's even a feature that will help you remove rolling shutter that you may experience with certain cameras. DaVinci Resolve also includes similar tools, which although they have different names, they essentially do the same thing, with the only feature that it lacks being the specific tool to remove rolling shutter. Because of this, I'm going to give the slight edge to Premiere Pro and Warp Stabilizer in this area, but like I said, there are a lot of similar settings here overall. And by the way, if you want to learn more about these specific tools that DaVinci Resolve uses, because in my opinion, they are a little bit more complex and not quite as easy to understand out of the box, I have good news. I have a cheat sheet that I put together of the best settings for DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer, and you can download that cheat sheet for free down in the video description. Back to Warp Stabilizer versus DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer. Now, there is another significant difference between these two stabilizers that you may not be aware of, because at first, it isn't visible in any of these settings, and you won't experience it whenever you first start using these effects, but this is definitely a difference that you should be aware of. Here's the deal. Whenever you edit a video in Premiere Pro and you add any effects like Warp Stabilizer to any of your clips, all of this stabilization data is going to be saved to your Premiere Pro .proj file. Alternatively though, DaVinci Resolve uses a database system which saves all of your edits and effects and stabilization to this database instead. The reason you need to be aware of this is that anytime you add this Warp Stabilizer effect to a video clip, that is going to make your Premiere Pro project save file bigger and bigger, and it can really balloon in size up to 50 megabytes, 100 megabytes, etc. if you add Warp Stabilizer to a lot of clips in your project, which I realize 50 megabytes may not sound that large, but whenever it comes time for Premiere Pro to save your project, this can take quite a long time. If you have a large project, we're talking 30 seconds or even 1 or 2 minutes, which can really slow down your editing speed, especially if you're saving your project often, which you should definitely be doing. With DaVinci Resolve, on the other hand, I've never experienced any slowdown, even adding stabilizer to a lot of clips, and I believe that is due to Resolve using this database system to save your project. So this is definitely something to keep in mind, and I'm going to say that I really like Resolve's database system and the way that it handles things better than Premiere Pro when it comes to stabilizing a lot of video clips in a project. So in the database versus project file category, I guess I'll give it to Resolve. You didn't know that was going to be a category, but it is. So which one of these stabilization systems is best? I've been putting Premiere Pro Stabilizer versus DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer head to head this entire video, but which one comes out on top? Well, in my opinion, if I had to crown a winner, it's going to be DaVinci Resolve by the smallest of margins, because its stabilization effect usually looks great by default when you apply it. But let's be honest, you aren't going to be switching your editing software because of a stabilization effect. Both of these programs have great stabilization. Yes, Premiere Pro takes a bit of tweaking with Warp Stabilizer to get it right, which is why I made free presets for you that you can download down in the video description. But on the other hand, DaVinci Resolve also makes a pop-up appear that will not let you do anything else until your clips have been analyzed. So both of these effects have their strengths and weaknesses. Like I said at the start of this video, you can tell me if I'm right or wrong in the comments. I would love to hear your feedback and experience of working with these two effects if you've edited both in Premiere and Resolve, and I really want to know which one you think is superior. I would also love to know what other effects and features you would like to see me compare between these two programs head-to-head. Remember, I have those Premiere Pro Warp Stabilizer presets and DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer cheat sheet linked down in the video description. Please feel free to download them and subscribe so you can see the next video in this series. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.